Gout is an important case for university examination, and it is a disorder of nucleotide metabolism, that is purine nucleotide metabolism. So in introduction, it is a disorder of purine nucleotide metabolism due to excessive production of uric acid. It typically involves the first metatarsophalangeal joint of great toe in the 90% cases. Other joints are also involved, that includes the knee joint, ankle joint, wrist joint, and other joints. They are involved, but they are less common. It typically affects the cooler areas of the body. There is inflammation and arthritis that causes intense excruciating pain in the affected joint. There are two main types of gout. The first one is the primary gout and second is the secondary gout. When there is defect in the purine nucleotide metabolism, it is known as primary gout. And when it is due to the other causes, it is known as secondary gout. The normal serum level of uric acid, it is in male, it is 3 to 7 milligram per deer. And in females, it is 2 to 5 milligram per deciliter. When the serum level goes above the 7, this uric acid, it get precipitated and it get deposited in the joints, results in the formation of tophi. So uric acid deposition in the joint is lead to the formation of tophi, and this gives the excruciating pain in the joint involved. So this uric acid or its product, that is monosodium urate, it get deposited in the joint. This uric acid, it get deposited in the renal tubule due to the acidosis, and it causes renal stones. It is a diabasic acid. It has pKa value. It has two pKa value. First one is the 5.7 and second is 9.8. In the renal tubule, due to the acidic urine, it is precipitated as uric acid, which is a less soluble form of uric acid. This is less soluble, monosodium urate. This is the 10 times more soluble than uric acid. So uric acid get precipitated in the renal tubule due to the acidic environment. While in the plasma, it is, the pH is 7.4. So in plasma, it is present in ionized form, in the form of monosodium urate crystal. And this monosodium urate crystal, when uric acid level goes above 7, it get deposited in the joint, synovial fluids, in the joint, in the synovial fluid, and it leads to the inflammation of affected joint that causes intense pain. Now coming to the primary causes of gout, when the metabolism of purines, it is involved, it is known as primary gout. The causes includes, there are five important causes for primary gout. The first one is the increase activity of PRPP synthetase. Second, increase activity of PRPP glutamyl amidotransferase. Third one is HGPRTase, hypoxanthine guanine phosphoribosyl transferase deficiency. Then glucose 6 phosphatase deficiency, that is in von Goeg's disease. And fifth cause is increased activity of glutathione reductase. So these are the 5 important primary causes of gout. Now coming to the metabolic pathway, this glucose 6 phosphate, it is a starting point in the HMP shunt. This glucose 6 phosphate is converted into glucose in the gluconeogenesis by the glucose 6 phosphatase enzyme. So decrease activity of glucose 6 phosphatase causes increased level of glucose 6 phosphate, which enters the HMP shunt, leads to the generation of ribose 5 phosphate. Ribose 5 phosphate in the purine nucleotide synthesis gives IMP, that is inosine monophosphate, which leads to the increase in the uric acid synthesis. This is why in von Goeg's disease there is hyperuricemia. This glucose 6 phosphate, it gives ribose 5 phosphate. It is a starting material for nucleotide synthesis, or it is a precursor molecule. This ribose 5 phosphate, it is converted into phosphoribosyl pyrophosphate by the enzyme PRPP synthetase. This is the synthetase. So overactivity of this enzyme lead to the increased nucleotide synthesis, which ultimately lead to the increased uric acid production and gout. Then this PRPP, it is converted into 5-phosphoribosyl amine with the help of glutamyl amidotransferase. So overactivity of this glutamyl amidotransferase lead to the increased nucleotide synthesis and increased uric acid production. Now this, through the various steps, it is converted into inosine monophosphate. And this inosine monophosphate, it is converted into hypoxanthine, xanthine, and ultimately uric acid. So hypoxanthine, xanthine, and uric acid. Now in the purine salvage pathway, this hypoxanthine, it is converted into IMP, and this IMP, it is converted into GMP and AMP, adenosine monophosphate and guanosine monophosphate. So in purine salvage pathway, this hypoxanthine is converted into IMP, and this guanine, it is converted into GMP. Due to the deficiency of this HGPRTase, which is required for these steps, there is increased accumulation of PRPP, which is required here. PRPP, it is required in this reaction. So there is increase in the deficiency of HGPRTase, which is also lead to the Leishmanian syndrome. In this, there is increased activity of PRPP, which ultimately increases the synthesis of nucleotide. And this hypoxanthine, which is ultimately converted into uric acid, this guanine is converted into xanthine, and that gives uric acid. So deficiency of HGPRTase lead to the increased uric acid production. So So this is the glucose-6-phosphatase deficiency, increased activity of PRPP synthetase, increased activity of glutamyl amidotransferase, then decrease HGPRTase, which occurs in the Leishmanian syndrome, and increased activity of glutathione reductase. There is production of NADPH in the HMP shunt. This NADPH, it is a coenzyme for glutathione reductase, and it is NADPH then converted into NADP, and this and through by utilizing NADP again there is more synthesis of ribose 5 phosphate through the HMP shunt. So increased activity of glutathione reductase lead to the increased production of nucleotide and hence uric acid production. So these are the 5 important causes of primary gout. Secondary gout is due to the another causes which do not affect the purine nucleotide metabolism. The secondary causes includes mainly the cancer, that is leukemia, lymphomas, then chemotherapy, cancer chemotherapy, psoriasis and renal failure. These are the important causes, secondary causes of secondary gout. So gout, coming to the clinical manifestations or clinical symptoms, it typically involves the first metatarsophalangeal joint or also involves the other joints. So there is intense excruciating pain in the great toe. Clinical features, it characterized by intense pain involving mainly the great toe. The great toe involvement due to the increased uric acid production and their accumulation in the synovial fluid of great toe lead to the production of tophi, that is known as podagra gout. So pain is the main symptom in the gout. It involves the great toe. There is deposit in the synovial fluid that is known as tophi, and involvement of the first metatarsophalangeal joint, it is known as podagra gout. Then it also involves the renal, so renal system, so there is renal stones. Then management, first one is the laboratory diagnosis. In lab diagnosis, the confirmatory test is aspiration of synovial fluid and demonstration under the microscope, there is monosodium urate crystals. These are the negatively birefringent crystals of monosodium urate seen under the microscope via the aspiration of synovial fluid. This is the confirmatory test and it is an important MCQ. Then in the treatment, the main drug or drug of choice is allopurinol. It has two action. First one is the, it is a competitive inhibitor of xanthine oxidase. Second, it is a suicide inhibition. It converts this allopurinol, the xanthine oxidase itself converts this allopurinol into alloxanthine, and this alloxanthine is more powerful inhibitor of this xanthine oxidase. That's why it is also known as suicide inhibition. So drug of choice is allopurinol. The other drugs which are used in the treatment, the NSAID, non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs to relieve the pain and inflammation. Then one reason is there why alcohol precipitated the attack of gout. The reason behind it is the alcohol lead to the production of NADH, and this NADH converts this monosodium urate into uric acid, which is a less soluble form, and it precipitates the attack of gout. Also, some preparation of alcohol, they contain purines in it, which again precipitate the gout. So these are the two reasons, that's why alcohol precipitates gout.